Hi everyone, my name is Dilip and I work for Enterprise DB. Today I'm going to talk about how we can run simple query faster, especially based on the PostgreSQL. This is going to be the agenda of my talk. First we discuss about background of my presentation and my experiments, and then we define what do exactly I mean by simple query. Then we'll go through some instruction measurement of the simple query, what instructions we can see in currently in PostgreSQL. And then we go with our solution, what solution we have done for the simple query, and we see the performance result. And apart from the current performance result, we also talk about what we are planning to do in future. Okay, so first thing is like current design of the executor of the PostgreSQL is like very, very generic. It's designed to support very wide range of query. So it's like very generic and having a lot of extra instructions for the simple query. So when we talk about simple query, which is like very simple in nature and don't need so many conditional and decision making, but because of generic nature of the executor engine, we need to run that instruction for all kind of query, whether it is simple query or complex query. So soon I'll describe what do I mean by the simple query. Before that, what I just want to describe what type of extra instructions we are taking for the simple query. So if you talk about the current design of the PostgreSQL, it's like we are having the multi-level of processing nodes. Like if we talk about the update, inserts, it's just one operation on the one table. Still we have the multi-level of processing node. And that's maybe required for the complex queries because we don't know where the select is fired on which query, which table, and which table we are updating. Maybe result table is different, but the scan table is different. But when it is very simple query and we are quite sure that it's just one table is target and result table and scan table both are same, maybe we can do all the operation in one node instead of having multiple nodes. Same way, like if you are having the multiple nodes, maybe we need to manage the data structure at multi-level, like tuple table slots and all, we need to create at each level of node, expression context, and many more data structures. And apart from that, a lot of decision-making structures, which is infrastructure which is required only for the complex queries. And if you talk about simple, it's maybe a lot of decisions are not required to make, and it can be like very straightforward, and we can reduce a lot of instructions. And apart from that, a lot of initialization works. If you see the executor start and all, every time we execute the query, we initialize a lot of instructions, like we create tuple descriptors, we create executor expression context, executor state, and everything we create every time we run the query, which can be avoided in many cases, which we talk soon. So what do I mean by simple query? So generally, sometimes we say maybe the query which is not prepared is simple, and many terms are there, but what terminology I am using for the simple query is the query which is following below properties I call as a simple query. So which target list is very simple, which don't have any subqueries, don't have any function calls. The qualifications are very, very simple without any function calls and any subqueries, no joins and no aggregates. So any question about that? Okay, so first I'll start with instruction measurement. I use call grind tool and the cache grind for drawing the graphical instruction, what we can see in this graph. So I have done this for the couple of queries, like the insert query of the PG bench and also for the update query and PG bench TPCB also. So you can see for the insert query, I run almost 1,000 transactions and taken the result. What I want to mention here is, like, if you see the executor part, executor start and executor run, it's taking almost 28% of the instruction of one query execution in total flow. And if you see the next query, that is the simple update, again, I run thousands of transactions for the simple update query, what we run in PG bench using hyphen n. Here we can see almost 50% instructions are taken by only executor, including executor run and executor start. Okay, so here I divide instructions into multiple portions, that which part of the complete run is taking how much instructions percentage. So in this particular graph, I'm more interested in executor run and executor start. You can see taking almost 50% what we just see in previous cache grant report also. Apart from that, some instructions are by create portals and all these things. Actually, I'm not talking here because maybe at the end of the presentation, I want to describe them in more detail for my future experiment and all. So here we are more interested into executor portion where executor start and run. Yeah. This, yeah, it is prepared. Okay, so going further, I am further dividing the instruction taken by the executor start. Because we see that 50% instruction was by the complete executor using executor start and executor run. And out of that, I feel and we can see that lot of part portion of the executor start, like initialization part and all, we can avoid every time we execute the query. So because of that, I have again taken the instruction of the executor start that how many portion of executor start we can avoid. So if you see the division of the instruction, like most of the things is exec init expression, exec type from tuple. So almost everything, if you see apart from heap open or index open, maybe we need to redo for the next execution. Apart from that, everything we can actually store and reuse it. At least for the simple query. If you talk about complex, maybe a lot of complex instruction come and maybe instruction tree and everything is quite huge. But simple query, I think it can be used. Okay. So now, why especially we are using prepared query for our experiment? Because we talk like almost 20% instructions are taken by executor start, and that is almost 40% of the complete executor instructions. So if query is prepared, like we can, what we talk, we can reuse almost all the portions, what we do in executor start and reuse for the subsequent execution. And for non-prepared query, also we can have some optimization. Like one is the, what we talk about, the infrastructure cost. And second thing is maybe some other experiment what we can do during executor run and all, like simple condition push down and all, but maybe we'll discuss in next slide, next few slides. Okay, so here is like what idea we are following for implementation. So instead of disturbing whole executor and putting a lot of extra checks inside the executor, whether it is simple or not, I am making a separate contrib module. So benefit of making separate contrib module is like when we are talking about saving the extra instruction what executor is causing, if I again put some more extra check into the executor, it will again put extra instruction which is not good. So instead of that, I'm making extra hook what Postgre is already providing, and as per that hook, if it is unable, then it will just check if query property is simple, means we'll process all the target list and qualification list and maybe that join expression and see if query is simple. Then we go for the simple query executor, otherwise we fall back to the normal executor. And one more thing is if it is a prepared query, we need not to do this processing again and again, because one time we found it is simple, we can save the property into query and next time we can reuse that thing. Okay, so now I talk about what all experiments we have done with the simple query. The first thing is pushing down the scan keys. If scan keys are very simple, when we talk about simple query, it's always simple. Then saving the initialization of target list and qualification list, save the scan slot, save the executor state and expression context. Almost everything what is coming into the executor state, we are saving everything and reusing for the subsequent. So I'll like go through one by one and also the performance results. So first thing is pushing down the scan key. So since the qualification qual is very, very simple, we can actually push down to the heap and avoid fetching all the tuples and in the execute, instead of doing qualification in the executor, we can do down to the heap. And the lot of infrastructure which is causing because of tuple flowing from heap to the executor and storing into slots and all, we can avoid. So by using this experiment, like pushing down the query to the down to the heap, we could save almost 50 to 60% of instructions. Did you push it into the scan mode? Yes, to the heap. Yes. Yeah, he told that question is, are we pushing it to scan node or down to the heap? So we are pushing down to the heap. So first, I have done the experiment with this query. You can say simple select query, which have one equal condition on integer field. The selectivity is very, very low, means we are selecting very few tuples. And you can see almost 60% of overall instruction reduction. This we can see almost 500 million instructions with the base, and it's just 200 instructions. So here is the behavior. What happens if selectivity high to low? What is the behavior of that? So we see if the selectivity is like quite high, 10%, or then also we can see almost improvement of 7%, and it goes up to 150%, and maybe beyond. Okay, so here's the experiment of the same with the multi-thread. So we can see this performance is consistent throughout the multiple threads. I tested in my machine only, so it's 1 to 16 thread. Maybe later on I can test on high-end machine also, and we can see. Okay, so apart from this pushdown scan key, we talk about the next experiment. So these are the qualification and target list initialization, what we do in executor start. So instead of doing these initialization every time, we just do it once, store into the, actually we store into the, along with the plan statement and put into the cached memory context, so we can reuse it for the next time. So I can see.
So do you memcopy it?
No, we don't use memcopy. I init the expression within the cached memory context only. I switch the memory context, do that portion to that memory context, and directly pass the reference and store into the along with the statement. We have the name statement for the prepared query. Along with that, I store the pointer. Okay, so. By this experiment, I could save almost 25% instruction of the executor start. Apart from this, there are tuple table slot and executor state. So tuple table slot, so if you see like when we are doing the any operation, select, insert, update, we need to have the tuple table slot where we store all the information like a tuple descriptor, that actually the tuple getting from the below nodes. So here we have two type of benefit. One is we can reuse the tuple table slot. We need not to allocate memory every time. And second thing is we can reduce also number of tuple table slot. That is by, you can say, by merging the nodes. We see update node, we are having almost three tuple table slot, two in the update node and one is below select node. If you merge, maybe we can do with only two tuple table slots. And apart from that executor state, we can reuse it. We can assign only once, and maybe by some resetting some parameters, we can reuse it next time. And also expression context. So with tuple table slot and executor start state, we could save 5 to 6% instruction each. But it looks small, but combinedly, if we take all the things like 25% here, 6% from tuple table slot, and 6 from executor state, become huge. Others are scan descriptor. So once we do heap begin scan or index begin scan, whatever descriptor we get, we can reuse it next time by resetting some of the field. But in current experiment, my performance, I don't include this currently. And apart from that, also scan key, index scan, we are building the scan keys which we can actually save it, and next time we just need runtime key to be initialized again. All other keys we can reuse it. Okay, so here is the performance result. So in this result, I combined all the other than the pushdown scan key, all other experiments are combined into one experiment because both are separate parts. Pushdown scan key is the executor runtime experiment, and this is executor start type experiment, so I separate down. So this is the insert query of the PG bench. PG bench history table, we have insert query. That query, I run 1,000 transactions, and you can see the result. Total, we could, from 96 million, we could reduce it till the 70 million instructions. It is almost 25% of total instructions, and which is 60% of executor, total executor, not only executor start, which is showing 36 million to directly 40 million. Second thing is on the select, also we did the same experiment. This is the select query of the PG bench again, and again we could save, this is PG bench hyphen S of 1,000 transactions. We could save the 20% of total instructions, and if we talk about only executor part, is almost more than 40%. And this is completely on, instead of full PG bench, I did on the PG bench hyphen N, because some of the queries current is not, I think, fitting well for my simple executor. Maybe I'm working on that part because going for sequence scan and all. So if hyphen N, with hyphen N, I can find almost all the queries are like perfectly fitting for the simple executor. So with this also, I could get more than 20% instructions reduction on total execution and 35% on the executors. Okay, so apart from that, these are the instructions we talk. Now I have taken some performance measurement also, that what is the impact on the performance if we reduce the instructions. So we select, we saw almost we are reducing 20% instructions. So with 20%, I can get the gain of 12%. But that again, experiment is in my machine, and maybe we can take with some other machines also. But for single thread, I think it's quite good, this experiment. And with 20% instruction, we could gain almost 12%. And I have seen some gain in the scalability also by just reducing the instructions. From one client to eight client, if you see it, becoming from 12% to almost 22%. So now I talk about the future optimization plan. So in first few like pie chart, I showed like 50% is executed and what is the remaining 50%. So now my target is to see what is remaining 50%. So these are just above the, if you see, hitting the executor start or executor run. Okay, so remaining instructions are divided like this. Most of the instructions are coming from the portal management. We create the portal, portal start, portal run, including all of them, it's almost 39% instructions. And portal management, create query descriptors, and all. I feel that almost most of the portion of the portal management and query descriptor either can be removed for the simple query or can be like reused every time, if it is a prepared query and a simple query. Some of the things, maybe read command and all, is related to communication with the client, so it's required. But most of the portion we can see can be actually reduced or reused. So that is my conclusion, what I already talked. 39% are from the portal management, and ...18% from the query descriptors, and remaining are from like read command and get snapshot data, which is required all the time. So if we finish this experiment of the what is before hitting the executor engine, then we can save another 25% to 30% of instructions, and we combine total experiment executor plus the above. Before hitting the executor, we can save almost 40 to 50% of total instructions. Yeah, that's all from my side. Any questions? Yeah.
You said that you could have functions. Do you mean like operators? You can't do like where x is equal to y plus z?
That we can have.
Okay.
Yes. He asked that the question is, whether we cannot have function in qualification or we cannot have some simple expression like x equal to y plus b. We cannot have the function calls, but we can have the simple expressions.
Why? I mean, operators are just, they end up invoking a function. Which functions are safe?
Okay, actually, when I call by the talk, the function call means, suppose we are talking about one experiment of pushing down the qual. So instead of pushing down a simple expression, if I push down some function call, so pushing down the call means within the heap, we have, like, suppose we take some page lock, and within that we have to evaluate all the tuple and qual also. In between that, if you go for the function call and function call again, the complex query come or some other, go for some other evaluation, then maybe I don't know how long we are going to hold that lock. So I did not do the experiment with that, but I think it's going to hurt the performance of write or something else.
Or just make the whole system lock up.
Yes, possible. No, if it is expression having any function call, function expression, it was specially defined the function call. If any function call is there inside, I consider them to be the complex always. Expression is there, then it is not complex. Only function call is there. I don't know what is inside the function, so we consider it as a complex functions. The other option is also like we can actually handle the complex call. If it is mix up the complex and simple call, we can distinguish which is the complex part, which is simple call. Simple we can push down and complex we can keep. But again, this type of things can cause some generic nature in the query. And again, we need to have extra if and else, and which what we are talking about is not executing any extra instructions. And we are again executing the instruction for just checking out whether it's simple or complex. Yes, actually I want to currently implement with the best how much we can gain out of the executor if it is simple, and maybe when we go to real time and maybe many things we need to combine with some more complex nature also. Like I just talk about the experiment with complex plus simple. Simple portion we push down and complex we keep above and like divide. So there we may need to real time, we may need to add some extra instructions, but what is the best we can gain out of it? That is what. Okay. So first is simple target list, and there is no function call and subquery in the target list. Okay. So actually, when we talk about a subquery and all in the target list, earlier actually I have done the experiment with having some complex subquery also in the target list and some function call also. But I realized, like, if we try to save the target list again one expression only. If that init expression, if I save it, it have a lot of query in between, and that infrastructure is causing like lot of problem in memory, and is huge memory also if saving the complete tree. I'll take one example. Suppose in this simple select query in target list, suppose you have one more query again. So it is multi-level of nodes, right? So what currently I'm trying to do is everything is controlled by the single node, and everything I'm storing that expression. But if we talk about the multi-level of node, I'm saving the target list of that. In that subquery is there, I need to recursively save every target list. So managing so much of huge amount of memory and reusing that, maybe it can cause some complexity in the nature. Earlier I have done this experiment and found a lot of problem with the memory and so many leaks and all, but I will not say it is impossible. It is possible. We can save complete executed tree also, and my first experiment I have done with saving the complete executed tree, but that was, I think, not successful. And second thing is qualification also goes the same thing. Yeah. Then qualification is also same thing, and joins, if you go to join, again, it come the nature of like we have the multi-level of node. And again, the same problem of storing them. And aggregates, I did not do the experiment. I think we can try. Maybe complex hash table and all can again cause the problem.
But this will work for insert update delete. This work for insert update delete.
I did not get.
Will this work for insert update?
In delete, yeah. It worked for insert update delete select all we tested. Yes?
It just pulls out that and gives up.
Yeah, actually we are storing, it is part of the, you mean to say instead of plan node, we keep complete executor tree as a plan node?
No, within plan node, basically we take plan node.
Yes.
Yes.
Create each executor node and plan node will be respectively stored into each node. Yes.
So instead of that, whatever you want to save along with the cache plan, can we make that part as part of the plan node, which can be just handed over rather than allocating?
Yes, I think we can think of that. Because currently also, the, if you see the each executor state node holding the plan node, instead of that plan node hold the executor state node, yes, quite possible. Just to making it simple and directly storing it, I am doing this here, but that can be done.
It looks like that some of the things that we are doing at the execution can be done during planning itself and can be saved as part of the plan rather than doing them as part of the exit start. And then which can be used not just for simple queries, but maybe for
all the queries can be done, but yeah.
Not all the portions of all the queries will be that way, but the things can be.
Or maybe, yeah, what I think you are trying to say is like some portion we can save and some portion do not save. Yes, quite possible. Yes?
What's the availability of the compute
module? Oh, I did not get. Currently, still I'm working on that and it's just POC form. So I need to think that how I'm going to do like experiment by experiment independent or as a whole contrib module. So still strategy is not decided on that.
Will you publish it?
Yes. But which way, which format and what stays, in what state, like push down simple query, separate experiment along with the core executor or as a part of completely as a contrib and all, I did not decide. Any other questions?
It's the same question, I think. Do you think we should make these changes like this, or do you think this is just an experiment that we should? What? Do you have an idea of what the final changes should look like? Should they look exactly like this, or do you have ideas on?
Well, actually, I will consider this is experiment which can show that how much extra instructions we are executing for the simple query, which is actually not required, and which way we are going to avoid them, we need to still decide on that.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Yeah, thank you, everyone.